There are mockingbirds singing all around us. We spent a winter in Alabama and it reminds me of, and it kept repeating, and it reminds me of, there's a crest, really a crest, right?
You know, a lot of people are collaging, and people have always collaged, and there have been great collages. And though there should be an international academy of collaging and standards and certification programs, there are not, so far as I know, yet such entities. And at times when I'm collaging and increasingly into collaging more and more, I like the idea that there could be edicts or declarations or parameters or advice or a newsletter I could get, telling me how to collage better, though my inclination would be to simply to collage their damn newsletter and mail it back to their headquarters. But I collaged briefly in the 70s and 80s and used a lot of rubber cement. And I gave up, I'd say, 80% of my brain cells to rubber cement. And even with that, today, using only glue sticks, I can out collage anybody out there. They can come with their fancy pants, little eco-friendly, organically produced glue stick, lip gloss thing, or spray glues, or whatever they want, and they can get together whatever materials they want, and I can out collage them. And the reason is, as you might know, is I'm pretty relentless. I stay up, I collage, I assemble, I do it again and again, and only recently, and I wouldn't have said any of this even a few months ago, but recently I actually got into the zone, which is what I've been trying to do with collaging, where I am correctly straddling where I belong in the fight between order and chaos. And I've always had a heavy bias for the chaos side. And yet, whenever you impose chaos, of course, with that, by imposition, you've created order, and then you become aware of an order, and it's like you betrayed your intent. It's an eternal artistic battle, I think. Maybe it's a thought battle. It is for me. I don't like, most often, even articulating thoughts this way, that there's always a narrative logic or a linear logic, when to me, the real charm of most things we do is the distraction, or the impression it gives you, or the sense you get from a smell of a different time and a place. It's all interconnected in such profound ways that chaos seems to reveal more rather than scatter more. So I've always liked to go for chaos, and that's why I've always had a bias, I suppose, for visual poetry and concrete poetry and projects that a lot of people work on without breakdown of control or power. People contribute what they can. Did I answer any question with that? The collaging binge I've been on since maybe March of this year, I produce, and I have a full-time job and I work on all these art boards, but late at night I'll squeeze in always a couple of hours. I think I've produced 400 collages so far this year that I like. I don't like all of them. Invariably, of course, the ones I least like are the ones Dawn likes the most, or the ones other people. And I don't, you know, maybe they're probably right. You know, I accidentally stumbled on order. It's the poet bemoaning the fact that occasionally, whether you want it or not, words will rhyme. And it's not necessarily your fault. It might make you sound lame and make the picture look awful, but sometimes it's not your fault, and it was meant to be that way, and maybe that is what you should ultimately produce. And but that stuff does not intrigue me nearly as much as in this group of collages I've been working on, the ones that really look out of nowhere. They just capture something to me that I want to say harkens back, and that's such a fucking pretentious thing to say, but that remind me of what I saw in art when I was a kid. something that was just inexplicable. It couldn't have existed on this planet without benefit of that person having lived and done totally random things in a completely different time and place. That thing couldn't have existed. And to me, that's the art that charges me and fuels me. And in this zone recently with the collaging, I've stumbled on that. I've done collages, I think, that have that, that are timeless in the way that, not that they should survive or be timeless or called timeless, but they're timeless in that you can't look at it and say that this was made in 2014 or that this was made with these materials this year. They look different. They look otherworldly. And I like that. I like just stretching as far as I can go while still having enough of a tether here to return. After collaging for a couple of weeks, and it was a fun thing to do, and mostly because I was avoiding writing and continue to do so, collaging, it's not that it's easier, but it could be it's more exhilarating and refreshing and surprisingly fun and open, and I don't go to it with as many rules as I have with writing. I pre-edit so much, and when you try not to pre-edit, then you're pre-editing even more. But with collaging, it was just this way to just glue things. And to keep it fresh for the first several weeks, I would deliberately glue the opposite side of a piece I had cut out deliberately to use, and I used the reverse of it as well. And wherever I was gonna put it wouldn't be where I would put it. Now still there's control and territory and real estate and all this stuff, but I did as much as I could to defy a lot of the logic I was imposing. There's always logic, there's always order, but I was trying to minimize how much logic and order, and that's why there should be a national or international academy of collage. They'd send people over every night to arrest me or fine me for violating the rules of good collaging. And it's violating those rules that is thrilling until it hits the next year where you've created rules for how to violate the rules. So it's that eternal battle. And I may have bottomed out a few weeks ago on it. Now slowly I'm ascending out of the collaging world, fully unredeemed by it all. I thought, and I'm writing a piece about this, that I don't mind clutter, clearly. And I don't mind a table full of 1,000 different bits of paper that I may or may not use. So I'm very happy with that, and I hit that point, but it was always either raising the bar, and now I'm at the point again, happily, of lowering the bar. And with it, rather than enjoying the clutter, and this is very bizarre for me, clutter doesn't bother me, but recently, I clear off the table after doing a collage because I don't like the bits from the previous collage still hanging around, even if they're good, and I throw them away. And in my written piece, I could see that as a pejorative process where really a few weeks from now, I'm not going to be able to glue down a single piece unless the environment is pristine, unless the table is totally clear. And you can see right now it is not. Thousands of magazines, materials, books, and glue sticks. Right now, still semi-comfortable with it, but increasingly I can't work with the same degree of chaos to get the ideal dismissal of order on the piece I'm working on. So I can see it ultimately happening where I become like a neat freak and I have to like clean, get rid of everything in the house, the ultimate minimalist collage, one piece of paper, and maybe not even gluing anything on it anymore and have that as the final work. So I see that as the good storyline for this thing, to start at the point of enjoying the chaos of everything by trying to straddle chaos and order in the way that's most comfortable for me, which I know is more chaotic than it is for most people, but ending up at the polar opposite end of it all and demanding nothing but a clean, simple, minimalistic, pristine, one statement, zen-like, or I can't believe I said that. I hate that shit. It's like shopping at IKEA. It's like Swedish guilt. It's like the blinds matching. It's like caring that your plates look alike. But I could see, for the sake of the story, me heading to that, and that when I write this story, it will end that. It will end that way. The Collagathon idea is an event where I'd like everybody who's interested, who collages or doesn't collage or thinks collaging is just cutting the eyeballs out of every copy of Cosmopolitan magazine and building a city out of it, maybe a high school art class, or people who just take certain thematic things and do scrapbooking, crafty things with them. But anyone to come together in a big room and have access to endless pallets of paper, materials, old books, pulp magazines, newspapers, construction paper, donated paper, paper ephemera, brochures, maps, postcards, menus, matchbooks, scraps. I've collaged with pieces of paper I found on the street because you get a staining and a texture you don't find in other paper. But have all that available to them with the materials or big sheets onto which they can collage to just fill a room of people collaging. And they can collaborate with one another or not and do big group collages on the wall. But I want to stand at one point and collage with them, but ideally against them. And I want them to collage, and I want to collage right on top of what they're collaging, or even better, if it's a little kid, like rip up their collage so they're crying. And I'll re-collage that and show them how it should have been done. And I want to stand, I think I told you, like a chess master in Washington Square Park, turning around one play after another. I will collage against anyone, one after another. I am not afraid of a single collagist out there. They can't take me down. They cannot challenge my ability to one-up their collage. Well, they can challenge it. That's what I'm asking for. They should challenge it. I want them to challenge it. I'm saying I'm not afraid of them. I can beat them. The Collagathon is just my, in many ways, it'll seem like this passive, wonderful community, kumbaya, happy event where we get together and do an art thing. But really, it's just, for me, an ego frenzy. A heyday of the collaging blood. Let me stick you to the wall. So, that's Collagathon in a nutshell. I don't think I even hit on the subject.
There are mockingbirds singing all around us. We spent a winter in Alabama and